Actually, I come from a family that is so hard. My family, especially my mother's side, they don't have a successful marriage. So anytime I go to church, the pastor is like, God, I see spirits around you. There is no way you can get married, and a whole lot of stuff. I came to the all night on Friday. I was brought by a friend, a close friend of mine. And then when I came, I received everything that the man of God said we should receive. When I went home, that was yesterday morning, I was still, at least, I was so convinced, but something was still telling me that, hey, this family you are coming from, are you sure God can do it? I was there in the evening, then there came a text message.
Bible says, suddenly.
Please, I want the man of God to see and read the text message to your hearing.
It says, hi, babe. I'm sorry for making you unhappy. It's never my intention to upset you. I hope you will forgive me and agree to marry me.
Hey! Lord Almighty God, we serve. Lord Almighty God, we serve. Hey,
I waited just to get a follow-up of a call. When I received the call, I was so amazed. A guy that has promised me and filled me for almost 11 years. That
hey!
Hold on.
11 years ago,
yes,
he disappointed you.
He disappointed me.
He gone 11 years
yes,
ago.
Please.
And after the all night,
yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
he came back.
He came back and
asking you for forgiveness
and marriage.
Do you remember yesterday I mentioned her case?
Yeah.
That somebody will come to beg you for reconciliation.
Yes, Master.
She is the first person.
Yes, I've forgiven him yesterday. Even this morning, I've agreed to marry him. And then he even asked of the size of my finger to send money down so that we can do our marriage in June, because I'll be completing in May.
He's in Ghana.
He's in UK.
He's in UK.
Yes, please.
Anyone under the unction of my voice that has been disappointed by any man before now, 24 hours from now will not end until he will call you and apologize. In Jesus' name, he will come back. I have said it, and so shall it be.